Hey guys, Quicksilver Gaming here, bringing you another episode of Ultimate General American Revolution. This is episode 17 of our Let's Play. If you missed episode 1, I will put a link in the top right-hand corner. Highly recommend that episode. It's really good for beginners. Goes over the beginning of the campaign. And here we have... So Loyalists are alarmed. Faced with the threat of a continental army invasion, British officials in Frontier issue a call for Loyalists to join the ranks. In response, a significant number of Loyalist volunteers and militia units rally to the British cause, bolstering the defenses of the area. So two mini invasions of about 1,260 men, and looks like they're both in this corner. This seems like scripted, but not scripted. I've done a lot of testing, and I figure I'll show off where we're at in the campaign. It's September 12th of 1776. Our fleet is absolutely decimating the enemy. We have HMS Phoebe over here, 78 gun ship. We're just knocking these ships out for reputation at the moment. And what I've done is I've moved a bunch of men around. Oh, they made it over here. I'll show you. I've also unlocked all of the specialty units, which is pretty awesome too. And we, all of the specialty units that you can obtain in the game, we unlock them via rep gains because our fleet is just absolutely decimating the British. It's pretty awesome. But what I've done is I've moved a lot of men around. And what that's done is hopefully it keeps the enemy at Fort Clinton in New York, even though they could easily like run out and take Morristown, Fort Penn, all of this. The British are kind of passive in a lot of regards. We'll see if they're still passive in the winter. And then I moved men out to Fort Saratoga. Nice little force over there. And then a force up to Montreal. I think I have a unit. Yeah, I have another unit moving up to Montreal over there. So I'll have three regulars. And then, of course, the Army of Portsmouth with over 3,300 prisoners over at Portsmouth. It's interesting that we have so many recruits over at Portsmouth. I would like those to be dispersed to other locations. That would be really handy, like down over here. Although we have a good amount of recruits, I also realized that I should be upping my bounty. I had like a negative 36 or negative 40% on my bounty, so I upped it to 1.9, so it's 190 per 100 recruits. I feel at this point in the campaign I can easily afford that. Well, I won't say easily because the economy still a work in progress. It's an early access game. We know how that goes. And then I increased my salary to 0.9. So we're 0.3 in the bonus for both, as opposed to being or 2% for bounty, 3% for salary, as opposed to being in a heavy, heavy negative. I keep going back and forth on intelligence cost. The second tier is just so incredibly expensive. And I personally don't see a difference. We know there is a difference. Pandacrat has troubleshot this, but without something that says like, hey, you blocked this enemy sabotage event, you just don't really know if what you're doing is making a difference, and it's just absolutely crippling to your economy. So what I've also been doing is I did delete all of the militia units, FYI, and re-enlist different militia. And the reason behind that is like all of the militia units you get in New York, they're bugged to where they have the old model in them. And if you know what I mean by the old model, it's the model that's in the Lexington and Concord battle, where the militia are like, they're more skirmishers open order, and they're absolutely horrible. They act like skirmishers without any benefits of skirmishers. So they take a huge footprint on the battlefield. They like move back and forth on the battlefield. It's no bueno whatsoever. So we are, unfortunately this came early. As I said, it seems to be a scripted event, but usually it comes more along the lines like September 19th, September 20th, somewhere along those lines. I'm going to see if we can maybe intercept that invasion. Okay, well, we'll take this battle here. So that fort pretty decimated, or they just haven't recruited all of their men yet, which is great. So we'll take Fort Augusta, see if that does anything to these units, stopping them moving over to like Reading and Easton, because fighting the enemy in the frontier is obnoxious. We need them to move up to Fort Sullivan and Newton. Speaking of which, I wish there was a way in the game where you could properly defend your territories without like actually having your guys to go out and engage them. I wish there was something like maybe you had like a spy network within your territories and you have a thing called spy network. You had scouts or something where you could like spot the enemy and properly engage them, as opposed to the enemy like being able to slip between cities and get behind your lines. Doesn't happen too often, but it's definitely a fear of mine as the map opens up further and further. But let's take this battle of Fort Augusta really quick, and I'll see you there. Okay, on the battlefield, moving our forces out. We'll place these militia out in front, see if they can take the brunt of the damage. These militia are not going to be part of my frontier army. They're going to sit at Fort Augusta and be the deterrent for the British at Fort Augusta. I'll probably put another militia there on the frontier, see if that works. I felt like cavalry was necessary in this attack force. The attack force is going to be three regulars. Well, it's going to be Morgan's Rifles, who are regulars, but they get two skirmishers, and then two other regular regiments, and then the cavalry led by Mr. von Steuben, or von Steuben if you are an American like me, because that's how I pronounce things. I'm never going to get over that, but if you know, you know. If you don't, it's, well, unfortunate. Alright, so let's keep moving up, see what we can do to this fort. I think I've mentioned this before, I would absolutely love if they took something from the Total War books. And I've heard, like, Jackie Fish and other YouTubers talk about this, so it would be absolutely great if they implemented the thing in Total War where if you hit spacebar or just a button, you can see the final destination of your units. It really, really would help out in that regard. So let's continue moving these guys forward, move these skirmishers around. Where's our cab at? Let's get them around. Over here, you're probably needed more on this flank. Let's keep pushing the artillery forward, and then you guys need to push forward. You guys need to continue pushing forward. I don't know why you guys decided that you needed a crossover, but that is a feature of this game, unfortunately. And then let's continue moving the cav around. All right, you guys need to go on hold orders. Hold, get that 15%. Are we in canister range? They're in canister range, unfortunately. So our militia is just going to absolutely eat it. Can you guys please shoot the cannons? That would be absolutely amazing if you would do something like that. I don't know where the rest of the British are. That doesn't seem like all of the enemy there. Looks like one of the cannons was in range. Let's move you out over here. See what we can do on this flank. Oh man, that the militia is just eating it from the enemy artillery, unfortunately. Looks like we're like half in, half out of range. And then let's see. Would love our cavalry to get in there, but I don't really want them to take too many casualties. I feel like we are missing some British troops in this fort, though. So I'm not entirely sure. Over here, they're taking a beating. Alright, you guys charge into them, or them. And then you guys can stop firing, and let's see if we can take the fort. Alright, we took 130 casualties. I think most of that was the militia. Their cannons did a pretty good job there. But we've taken Fort Augusta, and we'll see if that does anything to stop the British from... Well, they might go and take Wyoming. I've left Wyoming wide open now, I think about it. So I probably need... Hopefully there's nobody left over here. Let's move you guys into there, and then actually need you guys to disband your brigade, and one of you needs to go to Wyoming, not the state, we've already established that. And then you guys can go over here, and then let's see where else we can kind of land. Actually, both of you go to Wyoming. Bring you back to Fort Augusta. And then we just need to scout out and see where the British are going. Looks like we have bad intelligence at the moment, which is unfortunate. Okay, there we go. So they're still marching this way. That's kind of annoying. Wonder what we can do about that. Okay, success on the frontier. After valiant and determined effort, the Continental Army successfully captured the Fort Augustina from British control. Through steadfast perseverance, strategic maneuvers, and unity, the Patriots triumphantly secure the town, marking a significant victory on their fight for independence. So 10 fur, 10 reputation, all that hoopla. Okay, so I really need to figure out how I'm going to deal with this. And this is actually looking to be a problem. This should be a bunch of skirmishers, which isn't like the worst issue in the world, but it's really obnoxious, to be honest. So let's see. I might need... Okay, you guys go over here. Let's see if we can get the enemy to maybe come toward us. Yes, 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 yes. Okay, go back into Fort Augusta, or as the little AI thing said, Augustina, which is not what it is. And then we'll see if we can fight a battle over here. I don't know where these troops are going. Hopefully they're just going back up to Fort Sullivan. That would be fantastic. And then we can get a battle. Why does the general not move in a direct line over here? Okay. Three skirmishers. That's fine. They have no cannons. This should be a rout on our part. Is that right? Our part? Their part? We should dominate them. There we go. That's the English I'm looking for. Simplified for me. Okay, on the battlefield, all our forces are jammed into this itty-bitty fort, and we're going to try and fix that, because that is not where we want our men at all. So let's get you guys, actually, you guys go over here, and these 250 militia that I just combined go over there. Mr. General, get into the battle. Unfortunately, these tier 1 forts, the cannons are kind of useless. So I try to move them out of the fort just a little, and then try and, even though that's a lot of militia, it feels a little intimidating. Not going to lie. Okay, thought I had 120 guys moving out of the fort with them. Oh no, I didn't. That was all militia. Okay, that's not fantastic. There's something wrong with the angle here. You can see where my cursor is clicking versus where my guys are actually going, which is rather unfortunate. Okay, I think I need all of this cav on the left flank. That's probably where I need to go. You over here. Man, I would just like you guys to form up properly. And then form up over here. Form up over here. Does it sound like really quiet to you guys? It's really quiet to me, just kind of odd. All right, we need you guys to hold. And then get the skirmishers into position, and then let's just completely collapse their flank with cavalry. I think that'll be fantastic if we can do that. So, thankfully, that these guys on the sides of the fort, they can actually shoot, which is perfect. And then you guys will charge into them, you guys into them, you guys into them, and then we'll move these guys up, and then actually move this artillery up. That's so already doing fantastic on that flank. That flank should be absolutely decimated already. As I said, it is just a bunch of militia. I don't know what British militia have. If it is, I would like you guys to not shoot into your own men. That would be fantastic. I don't know if they have brown vests or not. Okay, I don't want my cav going into the line of fire. All right, now you guys can do your thing. Let's get their condition back. I don't understand how our cav isn't running them down. Hopefully there's not that weird bug that there was before, where the enemy, like when they're routing, it's really, really difficult to do anything to them, because that was a horrible, horrible bug. Yeah, see, they're still, okay, they finally shattered. So that's good now. All right, let's get this going. Have you guys fired yet? Can we fire? Have you guys fired? feel like we haven't fired any artillery in a while. Need your guys' condition. There's an artillery shot. So that unit is cooperating. That's good. This unit doesn't seem to want to fire, unless you guys have seen it fire and I'm just going a little bit crazy, but it feels like they're not quite cooperating. What's your guys' condition at? It's going up. Up is always good for condition. You guys need to move up a little bit more. Move you guys out over here, and then we'll probably collapse on their flank. Okay, that was a fire shot from them. Condition looks great over here. Says charge in, and then make sure we are shooting units that our cav is not necessarily charging into. Maybe you guys should stop firing. Maybe you should stop firing. And then maybe you guys could charge in, right? And then you guys could, you know, charge in too. And then why not? Why don't we just have you guys charge in also, and, you know, just make it a big charge fest. Turn the artillery off. That would be handy. See if we can get von Steuben out here. Oh, you guys have no condition. Interesting. This is a big ball of melee. The enemy is completely routed, though, so there's some audio issues here. I don't know if you guys have noticed that, but the audio in-game cuts in and out. A little bit weird. I've been having a lot of issues with the late game, which I always like to, you know, remind people it is early access, so we're always going to have, you know, issues to an extent. Why do routing units like that? Okay, there's the mass route. Okay, they're good. Let's charge over here. Am I just like losing sight of these guys? Okay, that's a little weird. Come on, keep charging. Well, I mean, I know that they can't really keep charging because their condition is terrible, but, you know, keep trying. That's all I ask for. But yeah, there's are these guys shattered? I don't know. I'm assuming they're shattered because there's no flag left. So what I was saying is, like, the longer the game continues, the more bugs I'm getting in the late game, which, as I just alluded to, it's all right. I mean, it's early access, you know, there's going to be plenty of bugs that the devs are going to have to deal with. Like this flag going in and out is another bug that I've, you know, started to encounter. And it doesn't say they're shattered and they just like disappeared right in front of my eyes. They're the stealthiest redcoats ever. So I don't know what happened to them. There's their flag again. Who knows? I'm just going to end this battle. Alright, more lovely stuff. Privateer vessels conduct raids along British coastline, targeting coastal towns and villages that capture supplies, weapons, and valuable resources, weakening British support on the home front. That's actually a good one, plus 14 provisions. Not that we need provisions. We did have the event, the like Hessian fly, so I guess historically speaking, the Hessians, when they came over, had a fly in their, I guess, the straw bedding that they used. Oh gosh. Please chase down these units. Oh no, I don't need these units all around. But there's basically an invasive species of fly that then created a giant catastrophe for the crops in America. I don't know if it's like actually a fly or what exactly it is, but it's a bug. In game, it's called the Hessian fly. Alright, let's try and capture as many of these guys as possible. This is a nice thing about having cavalry, is they generally do capture the enemy units better. I'm not really seeing much going on over here. That's a little worrisome. Come on. Okay, those guys surrendered, so that's good. Let's get Fowl back into Augusta. And then let's just keep chasing Collins over there. Hopefully that'll work out. I feel like this, I'd like them to stay there, and then we'll just recruit another militia at Fort Augusta. That's probably what we'll do. Okay, Collins, he's out of our, well, no, he's not really. Okay, you go collect those materials foul, you'll go to Fort Augusta. Then we've got our forces at Wyoming. Come on. We're losing way too much cav over here. Alright, I'm going to quickly fight this battle and try to run those units down. As I said, this is probably not the best way to do it, but I'm going to be a little bit reckless and just charge forth and try to run down the British. That's my goal here, and if they instant break, I'm going to run them down with my cav, which is exhausted. So, I don't know. This plan, I feel like running down enemy armies is really difficult. Okay, there's only one. Man, these are the stealthiest redcoats I have ever seen. Come on, keep going. Run. Keep running. If we can just cut these guys off, that'll be fantastic. The stealthiest redcoats you ever didn't see. Come on. Cav. Even exhausted cav should outrun exhausted infantry. Okay, let's see if we can. Okay, thank goodness. They surrendered. All right. Jefferson, get back into Fort Augusta. How many people can Wyoming actually hold? Not as many as we have over there. How many can Fort Augusta hold? Not many either. So we are running into the problem of we don't have enough men. And then Wyoming, I would like to have a unit. You know what? You guys are going to go to Wyoming. That's your new home over there. And then you'll go over here. So unfortunately, our army is going to be very difficult to keep going on the battle map. We're really going to have to, you know, get a little cute, I guess, is the best way to put it. What do we want over here? Stable, I guess, is the best thing to do. And then Wyoming, I haven't really looked at Wyoming for a while. As far as our fleet, they are just racking up the reputation. Let's go Oath of Secrecy over there. And then looks like there are some more British ships over there. That's good. Our money actually went up a little. And then the 88 Battalion Resolve, which just gives us +3 army limit. I don't think we'll really hit that army limit. Let's go look at headquarters. I want counter sabotage. That is where I want to go now. And we have 67 reputation. So September 16th, always need to watch out for New York. That is a big problem. Our money is a little low. So what I'm going to do is sell this last ship, USS New York, and I've uppercased N-E because, sure. New England, that's right. No, New York, New England, not the same thing. Okay, you guys go into Fort Augusta. Let's have Von Steuben kind of look at what is over in Fort Sullivan. Hopefully it's not a giant force. That would be rather obnoxious. 1508, 2 militia and 1 regular. That's not bad at all. Over here, how's this looking? So, I feel like keeping our troops going is going to be tough. I might need to do something like recruit some regular Joe Schmoes over here and just, I don't know, grab a dude. Wow, these are all really good guys to be doing their thing. And then you'll just have civilian muskets. And what I'm doing here is I'm just basically forcibly moving manpower is the goal with them. And then when we go take Fort Sullivan, what we'll do, this probably needs to move out immediately over here. You guys need to move out immediately. And then we'll form up an army over here. You guys have a level up, which is nice. Let's go take a quick peek at headquarters, see if there's anything. What is this? Like +5% unit provision. That's okay. I think we'll keep stuff now for intelligence. I mean, we could always boost up our navy too. Let me pause the map here. We have tons of resources at the moment. We're building a warehouse there. Can we build, Fort Lavelle. Still building, turning itself into a fort. Fort Saratoga is a fort, so that's good. Kind of just showing off the infrastructure we have at the moment. And then Lower New York, we are definitely building up that infrastructure for sure, because we can build rum there. And who doesn't like rum. I think we talked about this in the last episode. Maybe we did, maybe we didn't, but really cool that there is rum in the game now. Why don't we just make our first university, so the University of Hatfield, that's what it will be called. And then let's make a fur factory, why not? And then we've got tons, so what else? Portsmouth, you're big. Let's make the University of Portsmouth? Yeah, that sounds good. I mean, not that we're like in dire straits for officers, but you never know. I don't understand what you guys are doing. Please go to your proper positions, take up your proper positions on the map. So yeah, we are basically just trying to hold the British at bay over here, and then we're going to attempt to take the frontier from the British. There is a mechanic in this game called Royal Fury. It is an interesting mechanic. If you take 80% of the settlements on the map, King George gets really angry. I don't know why he wasn't angry before. And he initiates a Royal Fury, and it's like a three-pronged invasion from like Canada and two sea invasions. It's pretty brutal because it's spread out all over the place, and then it usually coincides with like another invasion or attack by the British. And we don't want that to happen. So I did the cheesy math, and this is really gamey and cheesy, but it's kind of my like point to the devs that like your concept of difficulty isn't difficult for a higher-end player, and I'm not even a higher-end player, but like there's ways to get around the things that they quote-unquote feel are the difficulty factors in this game, Royal Fury being one. So if I leave the British with these 10 settlements over here, I will never proc Royal Fury. And that's just because there's like only, I think I counted it, 43 settlements on the map. If they keep 10, they have more than 20% of the map in their favor. And that will stop Royal Fury from ever proccing. And there's no reason to go into that corner. So just like little weird things like that. Like, maybe Royal Fury should just be... Okay, no. Go attack them. Move up. The army movement is, you know... We always talk about army movement in this game. It's not my favorite mechanic whatsoever. I hate that my guys are coming on as reinforcements. I mean, they are closer. Okay, here we go. No reinforcements. So we'll fight this battle. I'm trying to remember what my train of thought was right there. Oh, it was the concept of, like, difficulty in the game. It's too easy to be gamey about getting around those things, and I don't feel good about being gamey about that, but it's a mechanic I dislike. So I'm just going to say, hey, look, I can completely ignore your entire mechanic because there is no incentive for me to go north of Portsmouth. Like, there's literally no incentive for me to take Falmouth, Lyman, Fort George, Fort Frank, Fort Halifax, Fort Pinal, Castine, whatever that is called, Norwalk, and whatever that is called. And yes, I'm purposefully not pronouncing them because I've been made fun of for my pronunciation of those before, and I don't know how to pronounce them. Anyways, let's take the battle of Fort, is it Sullivan? Yeah, Fort Sullivan, see if we can do that, and then we'll probably roll up to Newtown. I don't know if it's supposed to be Newton, but it's spelt Newtown, and then whatever that is, we'll... I don't know if we'll go take Stamford. Hopefully there's a bridge there and we could have a battle of two heralds. I believe it's Harold Godwinson and Harold Hadrada, right before the Battle of Hastings in 1066. So I knew I recognized that name and my mind went somewhere else, but somebody reminded me as soon as they said Harold, I was like, oh yeah, okay, I know all about that. That's a time period I'm very familiar with, just didn't register. So yep, Battle of Fort Sullivan, enough waffling, let's go. As usual at the very start, I pause, give out orders, and then we watch our men move about on the battlefield. My skirmishers should be pretty good against their skirmishers. We do have hunter rifles. Oh, they have Virginias, hunter rifles. So we have a mix of Virginias and hunter rifles, but the base stats for American skirmishers are better than the British skirmishers. At least I believe they are. I don't like how, like, it says they're blocked. There's nothing blocking them. They are the furthest unit out. So I'm not really sure why it says they're blocked. We could always try to run over their skirmishers with our big cavalry ball, but yeah, you can see here, I mean, we should be winning. It's like a, well, it's not like it. It is a 3-on-1. Also, fully aware that I say and like way too often and it disgusts me. I used to do public speaking competitively, and I used to train very much to get filler words out of my vocabulary, and I have been tainted over the years for sure, and I'm fully aware that I say those words way too often, and I am attempting to remove them from my vocabulary. I just use a filler word there. As we move forward, I also every once in a while am cheeky and go in and edit out filler words in my videos. I do a lot of editing on my videos. I don't know if you guys... I mean, it's not crazy editing. I don't know if you guys can tell that I do a lot of editing, but I definitely try to take this somewhat seriously with, you know, providing the best user experience that I can. I cannot click on enemy units lately, and I feel like I need to probably reload the game or something, because I cannot seem to charge enemy units. Okay, they are maybe coming out. Okay, these guys are exhausted, so that might be part of why they refuse to target the enemy. I'm not entirely sure, but let's move you guys out. Let's move you guys up onto this flank. We need the cavalry to really rest and refit. That seems like it's going to be pretty important. Oh, I forgot to move you guys up. You'll go out on this flank. That's fine. Ooh, I don't... are you going to take shots or hits from our cannons? I don't know. I'm not entirely sure. The enemy seems to be pretty confused and just kind of doing our standard wrap around the enemy and then support our artillery with guards. Oh, wow. Grapeshot did that much damage to our skirmishers? That's really rough. I feel like there was a secret buff to artillery recently. I feel like they have gotten significantly better, but there's been no patch, so it's really just me imagining things, to be honest. Okay, let's get you guys, you know, a little bit. What are you doing? Did I really have you guys charge forward? I don't know. Apparently I did. All right, let's get these skirmishers out. Let's have you guys move up too, and then let's have you guys move up in support, and then you'll go over here. I think that's a good place for you. And then you can move over here, and these skirmishers can go out over here. And then that's the idea behind this. You guys need to go on hold so you have better... that you're firing better upon the enemy. You, please don't die. I would really hate for that to happen. Okay. That's not great, but we'll deal with it. And then come around that way. You're over here. Let's see what we can do. All right, so cavalry, just get around. And you guys, the skirmisher footprint is really, really big. Really big. I don't know. I would kind of like it to be a little bit smaller. I'm like torn on that. It's just, it's a really big footprint. And it's really unwieldy. Okay, keep firing. Hopefully our artillery fires. I haven't seen our artillery fire, so that's a little concerning, to be honest. Let's have you guys move up. And then have you guys move up. You guys come around that way. Seriously, is it not firing? There we go. Now it's firing. Talbot surrendered and then went back. Okay. Yep, that seems to be something that happens often. Alright, can we move you up a tad more? Or is that... no, let's just leave you where you are. This hole right here is actually not good. I just realized. Oh, come on. Yeah, the enemy is going to charge for that hole. Can you guys run? And then we'll actually place you guys over here. And then, yeah, we're just trying to surround the enemy at this point. You guys need to go on hold. Oh, Talbot surrendered for the 50th time. Perfect. Please don't run in front of the artillery. That is a terrible idea. And then you guys move out over here. And then just really trying to hit this fort as best as possible. All right, you have been forced into submission. That was pretty devastating. Absolutely devastating. Absolutely love it. Love, love, love it. And then can you guys... I don't know if it's a good idea for you guys to charge in, but we'll start pushing up. So let's see. Let's bring the guard in. I think that's important. Oh, those guys retreated. That's not good, but we'll deal with that in a moment. Oh, you need to actually get into the battle. You guys retreated. And then let's move the cavalry up. The guards are now in, theoretically, are they in position? I can't exactly tell. This seems a little bit off, but we'll make do. You know what, can you go here and then you guys retreat a little? You guys could maybe go more like so. And you guys could maybe go more like so. That would be great. And then keep moving up. You guys could charge into... I don't know. Okay, they surrendered at the mere thought of cavalry moving forward. We should get a lot of surrenders because they're surrounded and there's no way out. It's kind of like Balin's tomb in Moria. All right. Now's time to charge like crazy. And then the artillery needs to stop firing. That is a major lag spike. I don't know what causes the major lag spikes, but they've been happening more and more, and it's really weird. So I'm not entirely sure if anybody knows why, and we can maybe talk to the devs about why there's some major performance issues like that. But I don't know if you guys saw that major lag spike, but there was one. And if you guys are ever curious about the specs of my PC, I believe it's on my my YouTube page. I believe I put my specs in the description there. So not a terrible battle, 233 losses. We, you know, absolutely wiped out the entire garrison, as we should. It was a bunch of militia. We are much better than them, and we're a human and they're AI, so they're stupid and we're less stupid. There should be absolutely nobody left over here, and that is indeed how it goes. So what is this? September? Oh. Dang. There was a thing that popped up, and when I clicked it, it went away, as opposed to being a little news flash that came up. Alright, so what's going on over here? Taking out Albany and Ulmic. Never heard of that one. British love interesting names for their ships. I've just never heard of some of the names that they've come up with. Okay, why are we... Oh, we're not in... We haven't captured Sullivan yet. So let's capture all of these supplies. Capture Sullivan. Everybody go join the garrison. Oh, except for you. Hopefully... Okay, we got those weapons. Perfect. And let's see. This unit here... Let's have them leave the garrison, and they're going to leapfrog across the map. Hopefully the British don't get froggy and try anything stupid that they might regret. And then let's take a look at intelligence. So that we're not quite there yet. Is that fleet battle done? Let's take a look at the seaboard. And yeah, so we've completely... Oh, there's still a couple ships over here. So search and destroy for those ships. We should be able to... There we go. Let's go over there. I could, like, physically move them. New York. Great Fire of New York. 493 homes were destroyed. So something happened in New York. Nobody really knows other than it's a fire. I think historically, and I think that little blurb tells you that the British blame it on the Americans, which may or may not be true. I'm not entirely sure. Let's do a schoolhouse and probably a stable over here. These forts actually have decent loyalty, which is pretty cool. I wish there was a better way to increase fort loyalty, or I think I've said this before, but I think it was Oddball on the Discord said something like it would be cool if like forts just didn't have loyalty because there's no troops there. It would also be like technically the forts really shouldn't have all of these buildings either, because, well, I mean, it says 5,008 at the workforce of Fort Sullivan, so I guess it's more than just a fort. I guess it includes all the surrounding men in the area. So that's just a little thought there. We don't need one ammunition to piss. Oh, but then that'll poopy. Okay, well, we'll anger France a little. Nathan Hale didn't he already die? I don't know. I've tested out this part of the campaign so much that this like pops up all the time. So if it's already read, I'm apologize for that. But Nathan Hale, the American patriot, soldier, and spy for the Continental Army, volunteered for an intelligence gathering mission in New York City, was captured by the British and executed. So -20% reporting for 30 days. Rather unfortunate. All right, we're going down the intelligence tree, grabbing all of the counter espionage that we can. Let's look at the seaboard once again. Let's just bring our fleet back down to, like, say, Boston. That might be a good idea. And I wish you could do some sort of patrol, like patrol the seaboard, and they just, you know, move as they go. That's hopefully you guys are going into Fort Montgomery, and then you'll probably leapfrog over here. Let's have Von Steuben go take a look at Newtown. And if we can just shore up the frontier. Okay, so there's nothing in Newtown. Let's go take you guys and go over there. That's an easy pickup. Super easy pickup. And we'll move. Yeah, as I said, we'll be moving troops from New Haven. We'll probably recruit another one of those, like, I don't know, abled body. Oh, we're just gonna call it the abled bodies. Well, these are some good officers to be using for that. But it's literally just me mass transporting 600 men to the front line, because otherwise we don't have a good way of doing that at the moment. And I find that's sort of the best way to do it, because it takes forever for the game to move troops from place to place, and sometimes it's really bad at it. Like Portsmouth probably, yeah, I don't, what's going on at Portsmouth that it needs 1,250 recruits over there? So that's, you know, a little unfortunate. This is what my production queue looks like at the moment. I'm trying to build up a bunch of Pennsylvania rifles so I can replace those hunter rifles in my army with the Pennsylvania rifles, and that's chewing up a lot of my factories at the moment. I like having building up artillery. So I could, let's lease two, because we really need our Virginias to go up drastically. We're still building a couple United States muskets because we don't have enough Virginias to replace everything. Short brown Besses, we could probably go back to three per day, just looking at how many we have stockpiled, and that's kind of where our army is, you know, where we are at the moment. Let's go take Newtown, and then that might be it for the episode. So go sit there. Let's do some reconnaissance with our general. Pray that it's not like General Jackson at Chancellorsville, where he gets shot and by his own picket. That would be pretty unfortunate. And let's go take a peek. So let's grab you guys. Okay, you've already lost men, which is unfortunate. You have militia. Let's go take a peek before we end the episode. Just do some nice scouting. Something mentioned in the Discord that I really liked. I might have mentioned it, so probably why I like it, is I think it would be really cool to have scout cavalry, because that's kind of what cavalry were for. Or some sort of scouting unit that couldn't really cause battles for Ontario. That's interesting. We could, I mean, there's nothing over here on the frontier. We could easily clean up the frontier, I think, and just kind of leave a couple men. We're going to have to recruit some guys. 361 men, and they have 64 slaves. I mean, that's just a workforce, so there's probably a larger population. I wish you could actually see the full population. Doesn't look like it shows that. It's going to be winter soon too, and I do need to keep in mind, so Battle of Stamford Bridge will be pretty small. So honestly, we don't really need as big of an army as we have, and we have an army at Fort Saratoga that Ward could really just roll out and take Fort Herkimer. It's my favorite word. Yeah, okay, so there's nothing over there, so we'll probably do an offensive with Ward and an offensive with von Steuben, and kind of do a little pincer attack on that area. Can we get you moving on to that front already? That would be great. And then let's take one last peek at the seaboard. There are no British to be dealt with, so foreign relations. Britain has a huge navy, but there are no ships out there. We have absolutely decimated them. This is what the colony management looks like. Looks like we just secured Pennsylvania, so what is a good idea over here? They have, you know, not... We could probably do mining. That's not bad, to be honest. We could also do construction. But let's do mining. New Jersey. Let's see, Morristown, Freehold. That's fine. Where was I doing? Quebec. We were doing construction points over there. We'll probably swap that over to mining soon. And then the big one is getting New York back, but we'll probably just bleed them out during the winter. So that is going to be it for today's episode. Please like, comment, subscribe, all of that YouTube jazz. I really, really appreciate all of the support you guys give me. You guys are awesome. I love reading your comments. I love when you guys smash that like button. I love all the subscribers. If you guys haven't checked out my Civil War series that's going on right now, I highly recommend it. It's made by the same people who made this game. It's one of their earlier games. It's more of a linear progression. We're currently playing as the Confederates, and we're using a mod called the GMP mod, which was made partially by Pandakraut, who's sort of doing some freelance work for, not freelance, but some contracting work in this game, and he's a absolute awesome person. Really appreciate everything he does for the community. So I'll put a link in the top right hand corner to episode 1 of the Confederate campaign. It's a lot of fun. It's really difficult, but I really enjoy that style of game. Also want to mention that this campaign's kind of coming to an end. It's not as exciting as, you know, the first part of the campaign. I'm actually kind of struggling with the end part of this campaign because the end game is not fleshed out yet, so it's not really as fun as it should be, but it's early access, so don't take that as a negative. Like, I fully understand it's early access, and it's just how the game is. So I'm thinking of doing basically a how I feel about the game right now. Maybe it's like 5 things I love, 5 things I hate, and 5 things that need balancing, something like that, or maybe just like my honest review of the game. I also want to talk about the most recent roadmap. It's not really a roadmap, but the updates that Sterner releases to us, because there's some really cool stuff in there, so I'll probably put a video on that. And then another video that I think I want to put out is basically taking a lot of footage of this campaign and kind of doing like those 100 days things that people put out. So like, I survived 100 days as a Continental officer, and I would just kind of like be a narrative footage of this, but it might be more than 100 days because I want it to be a super short series. So it might be something such as year one, year two, or the first 6 months, next 6 months, something like that. But there's a lot that is happening in the background, and I just want to let you know that even though content has slowed down for this game, that doesn't mean that I'm abandoning this game. I'm just struggling to make the playthrough work and be enjoyable at the moment. Anyways, that is it for today's episode. As always, guys, until next time.